Hello guys and gals, it's me Sashu, yes, with another video. Usually I'm not doing a game review except if I don't found interesting game and share my thought about it with you. I have postponed my Tom Clancy's The Division game review since I didn't have time to make it on time, and there are already many reviews about the game. As we all know, the sad news about the Ghost Recon Phantoms, the game is going to be shut down on 1st of December 2016. For many people, GP was the best and favorite game all the time, with all the bugs, glitches that still exist even after the release on 10th of April of 2014, after being more than 2 years behind Beta Tech. After several months, nothing new on the front page of official GRP forum, after all the news about the game is over hit the forum. Seems like devs didn't make it to fix the game based on legacy Yeti engine. Well, all gonna miss the game and many people pray for GRP 2. So, is there will be a next GRP? Devs have leaves some Easter egg in the announcement by stating, "So, this is not a goodbye. We will see you soon in another adventure." Does it mean Ubisoft is working on GRP 2 or something like this? As a Tina Council member, I don't know on what as new project Ubisoft is working right now, but I know on what other games Ubisoft is working right now without having to be a Tina Council member. A new Tom Clancy's title have been hit the game news from while year ago. The Ghost Recon Wildlands, it's a campaign cooperative multiplayer game, which means you can play missions alone or with up to 3 more friends in cooperative mode. And like you, I was interested about the PvP in Ghost Recon Wildlands. Well, there is no official PvP gameplay demo or trailer so far. Regardless, the developers are saying there will be PvP mode, but nothing more than just simple utterance developer interview taken by a gaming news website. There is no official news or announcement about PvP on any official Ubisoft channel related to Ghost Recon Wildlands, and we don't know what are they thinking about having PvP mod in a campaign game, since it obviously wasn't in place at early development of the game. So in my opinion, this won't be the another adventure mentioned in the official endgame post by GRP devs. And continue looking at the other games recently being announced or delivered by Ubisoft Studios, it's like they're busy right now to fix their game of the year, The Division, with patch 1.4. Which also regarding the dev team
aspects, like we know PvP is a big part of the discussion. A lot of people say PvP is still not good enough with 1.4. We know that was not the intention with 1.4. So
regarding this state, the Dark Zone as only PvP mode in The Division won't be fixed soon. So this also not the another adventure spoiled by GRP devs in the official endgame announcement. So what would be the next another adventure leaves me with doubts. Anyway, while looking everywhere for the answer of this question, this summer similar online competitive style game have been announced as a free to play open beta, created by more than one game development studio, Kodansha, Nipple, Geeky Studio, Team Waffle, and published by Nexon. The game is based on the popular Ghost in the Shell manga movie, a first person shooter. As a player, you're jumping into shoes of cyborg operator, which are looking like humans but having abilities, and of course they are immortal as they can change their bodies with a brand new one and upgrade. I don't even know what I'm talking about. So does Ghost in the Shell standalone complex First Assault will be a replacement of Ghost Recon Phantoms? While Ubisoft figuring out that was a huge mistake losing 2 million registration at the first several weeks after official release of Ghost Recon Phantoms. Okay, what do we know so far about Ghost in the Shell First Assault? It's a free to play right now, you can download it from Steam or as a standalone from the official website. Don't go right now, we have a video to finish. So the game is again team versus team, it's again up to 8 players per team, match based game with so far 3 game mods, which are the same as in many other games. Like Demolition mod, it's the same as in Counter-Strike planting the bomb. One team is planting the bomb, the other team is trying to stop them from planting. 10 rounds in between, both teams switching their sides, the winner is best of 6 rounds, or the one who have more successful rounds up to 10. Team Deathmatch always remind me to Unreal Tournament. Run and gun like crazy style, but with teammates who can support you, carry you, betray you, or annoying. And my favorite one, and to many GRP fans, a greatest conquest mod, capture control points. In this case, capture the terminal. Same mechanics and much more intense compared to GRP. The maps are smaller than GRP, but the point and spawns are very close to each other, creating dynamic and intensive gameplay. All three available game modes are having default timer, which they will complete if you do not complete the main object before. Team Deathmatch have highest amount of score requirements in order to finish the match, announce the winner team, and timer in case the match become a prolonged, so the winner in case is the team who have highest score. Overtime for each gameplay mod is available, triggered by same amount of capture point number for terminal conquest for both teams. For demolition mod, planting a bomb start a new 40 seconds timer. Within the offensive team have the time to protect the bomb from defending team who is trying to defuse the bomb. The game looks great, it's not on a legacy engine. About hardware requirements, seems like average PC can run the game in full graphics details at stable 60 FPS. For more details, check video description. About the game economy, there is a level progression system in place together with ranking system. In the same progression, level up, you rank up as well. The level system also unlocks specific weapons and corresponding attachments, but if you would like to jump in directly and don't wait till weapon and attachment unlock system, a marketplace is for you. As well, microtransactions allow you to support the game and save some time of grinding by getting pack of in-game currency, let you buy your weapon of choice and all desired attachments. Skins are also available for your guns and operators, which are only available to purchase via other NX in-game currency. But with NX currency, you can't buy anything else than cosmetics, means there is no power creep provided in any of the available DLC. But to make this honest review, right now the current available DLC does not offer so much, like passing the progression or grinding system, and they are a bit expensive compared to the offered content. Also, the current DLC are a mixture of several in-game content, which may does not suit everyone. How grinding is the game? In my opinion, the game is not grinding compared to GRP. Currently there is a good rewarding system for just daily logging into the game. You have a chance to receive amount of GP currency, or GP or XP boost, which can carry you to level up or collect faster GP for your next upgrade, including daily and weekly missions rewards for completion. Means within a week of playing 1 up to 2 hours, you can buy or fully upgrade a weapon, or buy an operator license to recruit more than 3 free operators. Even there is not a huge differences between each weapons compare how much damage each one of them deal. Even the default M4 A1 is powerful enough to play with against all other players. Besides weapon upgrades, there are also operators upgrade, which are in 3 categories: ability upgrade, skill upgrades, and physics upgrades, providing additional bonus stats to your operator. Those extra bonus stats are not game changer, there are players playing without any operators upgrades and perform pretty well. But there is another side of the coin which makes the game feel grinding. In order to collect enough GP for your next upgrade, you have to play repetitively just few maps, which are only available right now in the game. Recently have been released a new one available in 3 different gameplay modes. Regarding Dev Team statement on the official stream, few more maps are in development, but so far there is no more information regarding or even a glimpse. Also regarding another statement, a campaign will arrive as well in future, but so far there is no information if such campaign will be based on existing Ghost in the Shell manga story or on the upcoming movie. In terms of gameplay, the game feels solid. Like in Counter-Strike, opposite players are playing with different type of character skin. Makes no confusion about to recognize your teammates. The shooting mechanic is good enough and feel pretty well. Each weapon has its own advantage and disadvantage and requires a bit different gameplay style. Of course, there are OP weapons right now. With my understanding, the game is in beta and future weapon balancing will be in place. Weapons like F2020, the same as F2K in GRP, and Saburo C30 Simular Assault Rifle are performing a bit better than other weapons in terms of accuracy and recoil. Machine guns are also available, but I don't have enough experience with. I don't think they feel OP, performing pretty normal. Regarding the SMG, there are several SMGs which are strong and even OP, like P90 similar to GRP when it comes to spray weapon. The shotguns are insta-kill in most cases, even powerful in more than 10 meters range. About the sniper rifle, game feels like they don't have too much place in. It's very static gameplay with snipers. Of course, experienced players can perform well with sniper rifle in any range. Quickscope is possible, but they don't feel like having a strong presence. The melee is performed with special cyber knife, which activate automatic kill animation once you approach the target close enough and can be interrupted by target. Regarding the skill use, if you are good at shooting, you can miss the skills or just using them in case. Something unique in Ghost in the Shell is the ability to share your skills. So if you are playing with cloak ability, activating cloak nearby allies can sync with your skill and become also invisible for the same time as you. Even if you or synced allies die, skill still running after respawn. But of course, skill like heat sensor detecting enemies behind wall are subject of a future balancing, since you can imagine that players using that skill can easily predict opposite players' movement or even pre-aim or pre-fire. As a team-based game, you can join in party with up to 2 more friends. Compared to GRP, the party can be up to 3 players, less than fire teams of up to 4 players. In terms of team power, the game does not feel so much team tightened. Experienced player can outpower a whole team without worry about how good teammates have similar experience like CSGO, while in GRP experience and skill weight are crucial of the final result of the match. But let's take a look at another side of the coin and list my several cons about the game. Speaking about gameplay, it's so annoying, the character collisions, since while sitting at one spot, someone can just push further you, disrupt your aim, or even worse, expose you out of cover. And not just the players, but also the in-game drone ability can push your character out of cover or start moving you. Many times I've been pushed aside, forward or backward by someone else of my team just came to the same spot, which sometimes cost me a respawn. Devs are aware of this issue, but for the time there is no patch news about character collisions. Compared to GRP, blocking your shots with the character's body in case two players are sitting at the same spot in same stance are annoying. Damage registration issue is also another thing that makes me annoying. The character's hitboxes need improvement. Sometimes damage is not registered. Game geometry sometimes is weird. Getting shots from a player who are not visible from your sight in regarding how much you're exposed behind cover. And of course, our favorite and painful topic about netcode, the Ghost in the Shell does not make differences many cases when you feel the lag. With many familiar cases like empty a whole clip in a target, taking damage behind cover, and more annoying, enemy disappearing or teleport from the wall. And more rarities when you see players' health bar jumping like crazy while taking damage. The in-game network ping player stats, as many players are having concern about numbers accuracy. Unfortunately, didn't get any info about server tick rate for this review. Speaking about servers, the performance is also not so good. Does the game have cheaters? Well, in every game there will be players to prove their weakness. But so far I can't say for sure that cheaters are popular in the game, as me and my friends Weptan, Velko and Bulgaro have been accused for cheating so many times. By the way, there are already many good players from GRP transferred successful in Ghost in the Shell First Assault, like Lady Just Kill You, Tifergen, Champs, Bushi, Invalid ID, Crow Alphas, Lidu, Top Bot and many more, which you can find discussing the game in the Facebook page. You can find the link well below in the video description. So if you are interested in the game, join in the discussion and let's see if the game will carry us and we will be carry of it. Okay, now go download the game, play it for a while, come back here and leave your thoughts about the game in the commentary section. As well, let me know what you think about this quick review, of which one I hope you enjoy and give you some insights about the Ghost in the Shell First Assault. As well, if you're looking to watch next, click on the annotations some here. Thanks for watching.